We want to simply inform the public that our task teams continue to investigate the tragic murder of Isma Ibrahim Tusubira, others used to call him Olaxes, alias Jaja Ichule. We put up competent teams from CID Crime Intelligence, Forensics, our IT Directorate, together with our Kampala Metropolitan teams to investigate this tragic murder by shooting of the video blogger and political analyst, which happened near his home at Chanja Central Zone. So we are continuing to gather evidence and interview witnesses to help determine the circumstances of the case. What we can confirm is that it was not a random attack, but a targeted incident where two assailants armed with one pistol emerged from their hideout near his gate, and the armed assailant fired multiple shots at close range, killing him instantly from the passenger seats. It was very unfortunate. His driver, Waiswa Mathias, remained unscathed without any injuries, despite the bullets which were riddled, despite bullets which riddled the driver's side. And because of that, the driver, Waiswa, is still in our protective custody, helping out with certain lines of inquiry. The two assailants managed to get away on foot. Our canine managed to trail the scent up to one of the main roads where it is believed they boarded a motorcycle and escaped. They dropped one glove which we believe was used by the shooter, which the canine was able to help recover. So outside the driver, we also have two other suspects who have been arrested. So together we have three people whom we are interviewing for now. We are also reviewing the entire movement of the victim and his driver from Munyonyo, where he was playing football at around 4 p.m. via the Entebbe Expressway. They stopped over for dinner at Nyakana's Bar in Mutungo, and they left Nyakana's Bar at around 8:15 for his home. There's another interesting part, of course, that our cyber teams are following, is that as soon as they left Mutungo, when they reached Munyonyo roundabout, the victim, Isma, received a phone call, and he asked the driver, Waiswa, to park aside near Munyonyo roundabout, because the person behind the phone was telling him that, okay, you wait for me, let me come and meet you there. So they waited for the person behind that phone call in vain. He did not appear, so they drove on until when they reached the gate at around 9:20 to 9:30 p.m., where they were attacked and the victim shot dead. So it's not clear whether the caller is linked to the masterminds of this murder or not, but our investigations will be able to establish in due course. At this stage, the motive of the murder has not yet been established, but there is a lot of rampant speculation about the murder by different bloggers, netizens, the media. Everybody is bringing out his version. But we call upon the public to remain calm and patient. This continuous speculation is a disservice, first of all, to the family and the public, because those many versions have not yet been verified. We are aware that some of his videos were controversial, but we are yet to establish whether his murder is related to his social media work or other motive. So our thoughts continue to be with his immediate family, friends, relatives, and all well-wishers. affected by the sad incident. Right now, our task teams, like I've indicated, are working diligently in trying to identify the persons responsible. We are building on the information from the three suspects, and we shall be giving you more updates in due course.